God comes to Abram and he says, Abram, I want you to pick up your family and I want you to move them to this other place. God doesn't give him a whole lot of explanation at first, but eventually he tells him, and I'm going to bless your family and generations, and you're going to have descendants that are more numerous than the stars, as well as the stars in this region. But God essentially comes to Abram and he says, Abram, I'm calling you into the unknown. I need you to trust me. And Abram does it, and you can read about that in Genesis. It's a really cool story. When I think about the example of Abram, when I think about my own spiritual journey, and I think about all of us, as we sometimes are too proud or too unwilling to say those very simple words, I don't know. Because when we think we've got it all figured out, we are essentially saying to God, God, I am okay right here. I don't care where you're trying to take me. I don't care if you've got something better for me. I am okay right here. Because I figured out that this is what's best for me. If Abram had done that, he wouldn't have received all the blessings that God had for him and for his family. I'll say it again. How can God lead us to somewhere better if we already think we're exactly where we need to be? Let's hit the next slide, please. now on another note. Does any of y'all know that cartoon from, like, this is like my age here? Anybody know G.I. Joe? Okay. Austin out there knows G.I. Joe. A couple of you. That's discouraging to me that nobody else knows this. I'm not that old. When I was growing up in the 80s, and they still do this now, but when I was growing up in the 80s, like, every toy had to have a cartoon to go with it so they could sell you more toys. And one of the cartoons that I loved, one of the toys that I loved the most was G.I. Joe. Now, I know, like, in the 60s, G.I. Joes were, like, a bigger thing, but in the 80s, they were, like, these little action figures, and there was just a whole bunch of them. And when you watch this cartoon, and Austin, do you remember this, the public service announcement at the end of the cartoon? You know what I'm talking about? Maybe, a little bit. These cartoons, they did it like every single time. They would do this weird little public service announcement at the end of the cartoon. It doesn't matter what the show was about. At the end of it, there was going to be this weird little scene. And let me give you an example. This is ridiculous. And kids, don't try this at home, okay? You have this little scene with this little boy named Jimmy. And Jimmy would be there, and he'd have like a fork. And Jimmy would be like, I wonder what would happen if I stuck this fork in that light socket. That's bad, don't do that. And before he could do it, the G.I. Joe character would jump onto the screen, and he would say, wait, Jimmy, don't do that. If you stick the fork in the light socket, you'll get electrocuted, and you could be seriously hurt. And then little Jimmy would explain with this oblivious look on his face. He'd say, wow, I didn't know that. And G.I. Joe guy would come back and would say, well, now you know. And knowing is half the battle. Yeah, you're with me now. Okay, one person is with me. Awesome. But that was the thing that drilled into your mind every time. Now you know. And knowing is half the battle. I was taught that as a kid, but as a Christian, as a follower of Jesus, as I've grown up and I've thought about it a little bit, and as I look at this passage and see what happened with Nicodemus, I've begun to understand that G.I. Joe maybe had a little backwards. Because I come to understand that in my life of faith, if I want to hear what God has to say, if I want to go where God wants to take me, that it starts with not knowing. I think half the battle, probably the most difficult part of it, is us by starting out saying, I don't know. God, take me where you want me to be. Let's hit the next slide, please. And it's familiar thing. Because we look at Nicodemus' example. And if you look at the rest of Scripture and see what happened. In this very simple but very important moment, as Nicodemus comes before Jesus and he says to Jesus, Jesus, I don't know. Teach me, guide me, lead me. Jesus says some very profound things to him that Nicodemus still didn't get. He talks about being born again. He talks about the way the Spirit moves. But if we look at the rest of Scripture, we see that God did powerful things through Nicodemus. Nicodemus, later on, is one of the Pharisees that actually defends Jesus at one point. Nicodemus is one of the people that tells us in Scripture that once Jesus had died, Nicodemus helps to take Jesus' body and prepare it for burial. Nicodemus' life was changed because of this conversation. God took him in a new, better direction, made him part of something much bigger than himself, because he was willing to say, God, I believe. As we go forth today, as we move forward in our lives, as we go to this week and whatever it might be coming, good, bad, in between, my prayer for you and for me, for all of us, is that we would be willing to admit where our knowledge stops. And that we'd be willing to invite God to make up the difference. God doesn't expect us to know everything. God doesn't expect us to have it all figured out. But God does want us to call on him to meet us, to guide us, and to take us forward where he has us to go.